What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Philadelphia and the Universal Open Rocket League East Regional. That's Independence Hall right there. As of course, we are in beautiful Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and it is now time for the semifinals. And semifinal one is going to start here in just a second as we have G2's A squad going up against the Leftovers. So we have a short amount of time for bold predictions. Tell me what's going to happen in this match. Who's going to win?
I mean, the Leftovers were able to stay on offense almost exclusively in their game against Tribune, but we didn't have to get to see them play much defense at all. And I think that they're going to have their hands full with Cronovi and Jazzo. I'm feeling good about G2A. I think that they're going to be able to take this one. We'll give it 3-1. I'll give the Leftovers one game.
I think it's going to be a 3-0. I don't think that they're not going to be close games, but I just don't see Rizzo and Steph losing a single one. I think that they're just going to be able to pull out clutch wins time and time again.
I said Cronovi and Jazzo, didn't I?
Yeah.
It's Rizzo and Stev.
Yes.
So it's even more.
There's just
too much
G2 love to go around. They're all here in spades. So we'll see if it's going to be an all G2 finals or not, though. The first half of that, of course, is going to be G2A versus the Leftovers. We're going to get into the match here in just a second. Here we go. All right, guys. So Wave, Quinn, take it away.
I'm ready. I kind of want to change the prediction to 3-0 now that I remember it's Rizzo and Steph, to be completely honest.
You can't go back.
We won't go back on it. I'll still give the Leftovers the faith of the one game. But Jelly and Bacchino, we saw them playing a lot of offense, but the thing was that when they were on defense, they basically were being gifted non-goals by inaccuracy on the side of Tribune. Wasn't able to score on the opportunities they
had. I think you're discrediting them a little bit much. I saw Jelly really some great plays coming from him. He had a good vision on the field. He was able to spot his teammate. Multiple times. It wasn't just like a one-time thing or when it's clearly the obvious play. He did it even at times where it maybe wasn't so obvious. He had great mechanics. I mean, to me, he's really one of the players that we want to be watching, and I think although he may be super skilled here, he's just not going to be able to take out a win against Rizzo instead of two mainstays of the professional scene.
Yeah, I think that these guys have it on lock, especially with how young this level of a 2v2 scene is. I think the players that have the mechanical skill that G2 does are going to be able to take it out on a team that even if they exclusively play 2v2, I still think G2's got this, but we will see. Definitely put G2 on upset alert just in case. You never know. Guys, what a shot. It bounces off the post from Stev. This will mean Jelly is able to move this one upfield. G2 in the blue. Leftovers in the orange. Rizzo on the top. Playing this one away. Jelly now. He'll fall back. Allows Stev just to have ball control in the midfield.
Yeah, Stev actually missing the boost there means he's not going to be able to make a great play. Without boost, you really can't do much on the walls at all. So that was a huge hindrance, I think, for Steph.
Oh, what? That just slips through a defender and the post. That was a beautiful shot. I don't think he meant for it really to be a shot, but hey, he'll take it. 1-0 G2.
Oh, that's heartbreaking there for Bakadu.
He did touch it. Never mind.
Yeah, he tried to go back to catch the ball before it could sneak behind him, but it was already there, and he just puts it into his own net.
Close stuff.
I mean, we're going against G2 as well. Like, that's just you really don't want to do. So handy to take the lead early because it lets you not worry so much about.
Oh, Steph finds the angle, too. What an excellent read on that bounce. 2-0 G2.
Yeah, I mean, just to continue, I mean, it lets you not have to worry about taking too many risks to be able to make the comeback. And we see Steph already there, one goal up. They can now pick and choose. Now two goals. They can pick and choose their opportunities that they go for. There's no pressure whatsoever. The onus is on Jelly and Bakadu to be able to make the plays happen.
Absolutely. I mean, G2 technically could just hunker down on the defense if they wanted to. As we've seen many times in Rocket League, that's not necessarily the best strategy. At this point, just continuing to do what is already working. Just no reason to change up your strategy right now. Both Stev and Rizzo very aggressively in the box of the opponent there. Rizzo in the corner and Stev in the goal. Not connecting successfully on that pass play, but they weren't able to transition out quickly enough. G2 able to get back onto their own half. You see Stev moving to goal. Rizzo choosing to contest in the corner instead of going for net. That's going to get them punished. Baka will score.
What a touch here. I think Jelly actually a little bit fortunate here as Rizzo demoing Jelly actually gave him momentum to hit the ball way harder than Jelly would have been able to. So Rizzo's bump coming back to bite him. He thought he was leaving any pressure, but he actually just gave Baka a sick pass.
Yeah, well, we're talking about Baka there making the shot. Does this go in? No, Stev will block it away. Baka able to read a demolition pass. This is one of the more difficult things to read. Excellent play there. We've got Leftovers on the board here in game number one, a best of five. We've been playing best of threes, but now you're going to have to win three games to send it all the way through. Stev, try and play this one through. blocked away. He'll fall back and let Rizzo in the midfield try to pick it up. Stev on the wall. Rizzo waits patiently in net, waiting for Stev to start to move backwards before he makes his move outward. Oh my goodness. Look at these plays from the leftovers. They tie it back up.
Yeah, great shot here, actually. A really unfortunate 50-50 there for Riz. I think he could have approached that a little bit differently, but a great shot coming from Jelly, able to capitalize on that wide-open goal.
Well, and when you take the time that Rizzo did to allow his teammate to move back, you're also giving time to your opponents to set up and figure out what they want to do, to read the situation. And in that situation there, Leftovers comes out with the victory, but an open net. Can Rizzo put it in? He will. They immediately gain their lead right back.
I mean, just catching Jelly and Buck asleep in here. We see Steph, he goes on the wall, he takes his time. He sees Jelly backwards going for boost, and just that bounce off of the very bottom. There's a tiny little ramp there on the bottom of the field, and those bounces can be so, so punishing for defenders, and it just pops up perfectly for Rizzo to put it in under the crossbar.
Now G2 back with the lead. After sacrificing that 2-0 lead, they're going to look to see if they can make it 2 again. Blocked away, but the pressure stays on here. Steph has to make contact here, or else it would be a goal on the other side.
Yeah, great job from Steph to push that ball sideways. Instead of letting the clear happen, he just maintains pressure. Even though he's not able to rotate, he buys time for Rizzo, who needs boost and needs to reposition himself.
Steph on the wall. Back to wrap this one around and then leave it. Respects Rizzo, tries to bait him in, works successfully now, and Jelly be able to move out. Rizzo's going to got to be low on boost in the midfield. Baca plays this one down. This is how they scored the first goal. Can Rizzo get the clear this time? He plays it across the net, and Jelly pitches it in again. You got to be questioning the G2 rotations right now.
No, this isn't even the rotation. This is just Jelly calling out Rizzo.
But see where Rizzo comes in from?
Oh, no. Rizzo did not expect to get that much power on the touch. You see, he hit the brakes after he tapped the ball. He was expecting the ball to move forward, but he wanted it to stay on the outside of his car. So he had his full car behind it, but it didn't move too far forward. He was unable to stay behind it and prevent the goal.
That's definitely, I still think if he had rotated into net, it might have been a better situation, but you're totally right about that. And they put in another one.
What?
We were still talking about the last one. Come on, hold on, guys. Here, Rizzo on the wall to
and
send it out.
Jelly.
He just lobbed it into the
net. That's just a. Oh, that's unfortunate there. And Jelly is. I feel like this guy's everywhere on the field. He's always there to capitalize. And, I mean, we mentioned earlier, this is the guy who I think we need to look at between him and Baca. He's the guy who's been impressing time and time again. And Baca's been living up to the challenge, letting Jelly pressure as much as he wants to and is doing his part to. To maintain the status quo.
Oh, Baco gets the block, but is there any pressure in? Steph fakes him out. Is Rizzo there to take the shot? No, Jelly's there first. He'll play that one away. G2, their counterpart G2B, blew 2-0 leads twice earlier, and now G2A has blown one of their own, and now they are down by one on some critical errors that Jelly has been able to punish. Jelly putting his team on his back right now, being the player he needs to.
Great car control from Rizzo there. He recognizes the demo's coming and he pops the ball and stays right underneath it, turning his car even to maintain control and avoid the demo. I think what we see, the difference between the G2A roster and the G2B roster, is the G2A roster seems to be...
Oh, there we go. Rizzo puts another one in, tying it back up at 4.
I mean, I mentioned earlier, it seems to be in a lot more control as a whole. We see Steb and Rizzo on the wall. Rizzo, great communication there with Steb. He's able to get there first of the ball, and Steb also rotating back. It's just solid 2v2 play. We talk about 2v2. A lot more goals get conceded, a lot more opportunities for goals get conceded because it's so focused on the individual play. Just a tiny error where you get bailed out in threes, you don't get bailed out in twos.
Ooh, Steb, what a play after being loose in net. Makes the save, keeps this tied up, and now Rizzo's got ball control, pushing enemy territory, but Jelly with the pitch, the dunk off of the hood at midfield. It's 5-4 leftovers.
This is all Rizzo just dribbling a little too much. He's not expecting them to challenge them the way they are. And when you go on a 50-50, and one of those challenges on the outside walls, right at the halfway field, whoever's on the inside, the ball's more likely to go in their favor. So we see the ball just go straight into Rizzo's net. This isn't the first time I've seen this kind of thing happen to G2, where players start to dribble a little too much and then they just get challenged time and time again and capitalize on it. And we see Jelly and Baca able to make great use of this situation. Or circumstances.
With an opportunity, can he put this one in? Is it just going in already? There's been a few goals like this. I can't believe this game right now. The record in RLCS for most goals scored in a game is 11, and we will have 11 in this game. They will tie that here, and we're not even through the first day of this Universal Open. These guys, you said earlier, more goals conceded in 2v2 than 3v3. You're seeing a great example of that here as G2 ties it back up.
Oh, Bako.
Super important touchdown for Rizzo. That net was wide open.
Yeah, he looked for the bump on Steph, but then thought better of it. Now Steph moving this one up. Rizzo far in the back, watching, not wanting to fall prey to the unfortunate pinch. As the timer clicks down, we'll most likely have overtime again, unless we see some last-minute heroics here from Steph to Rizzo. The shot towards the net, he doesn't make contact. We'll have overtime in game one.
Such a close opportunity, but Rizzo unable to get up in time. That was a very fast click there from Steph. They can be a little difficult to predict.
Bako lofted. He's giving a good example of why aerial plays are dangerous in 2v2. He's now very far in his own and enemy territory. He's having to fall back. You know he's low on boost as well. Steph just trying to buy time, seeing if he can bait in both defenders and give the ball to Rizzo. Right now, Bako coming off the wall again. Rizzo just waits for it. He'll fall back and let Steph take control. This one in the back. Jelly plays it over the top of Steph. Steph goes and just muscles Jelly out of the way. Rizzo's got a lot of space. His pass Jelly, the shot across field. Bako is moving up just to try and buy time for Jelly to get back behind him. Maybe pick up some boost on his way. Here comes Jelly in, the shot towards the net. Both players lofted. Does anyone get there? Steph does. He plays it to the side. We'll keep on playing through here. Remember, in overtime, it's Golden Goal. First team to score wins.
Wow, we see a lot of pressure there coming from Jelly and Bako. G2A is unable to seem like he can deal with it.
Can he do it? Just lofted. Rizzo thinks better of it. It falls.
What?
No! Can they do this? Oh, dear me! Bako almost scores two own goals in one game.
Barely off that crossbar. Not crossbar, the post, excuse me.
Dodges the bullet. We'll keep playing into the second minute of overtime. Rizzo across the field, connecting with Steph. It's wide. Can Rizzo put the cross? No, it's too high.
He tried to recorrect Steph's shot to put it back on target because Steph was able to, or just missed the shot, excuse me. And Rizzo, as a result, had to put the ball above the crossbar. We see opportunities here, but
does Steph commit? 1v2. Jelly's on the wall. He plays over the side. No, Steph hung in the back. Now he'll move up. Keeps the wide rotation. The shot towards the net saved by Bako. Both teams did the right thing in that situation. Rizzo put it past one. He's got two in the corner now. Nobody in a good position to shoot here for the leftovers as Steph passes towards Rizzo. He'll pass it back to Steph. Takes the shot towards the net. Bako gets the save. Steph shot it right at him, to be completely honest. Mm-hmm. And we'll continue to play on here into the third minute of overtime.
Yeah, just poor shooting, and it isn't the first time it's happened actually this game.
We've seen it goes in! Bako scores, and the leftovers take game one.
I stand corrected.
Look at this.
They take a game. I didn't think this was going to happen, but Rizzo there, he was unable to do anything. That was just an incredible bouncer off of the corner, and we look at Rizzo and Steph sitting there. It looks like in silence. I mean, I think they must be a little bit shocked, like, unable to believe it.
To be completely honest, Rizzo's usually quiet, but 13 shots from G2A, only 5 goals, 9 shots, and 6 goals from the leftovers, slightly more efficient. 4 saves to 5 saves. Very, very even game. Can you believe that it's this close here? This is what it's all about here in the semifinals.
Yeah, I mean, the one thing that I think was key to look at is this. It's to see that how much G2A actually invited pressure on themselves. They tried to slow the field down a little too much. And even though they scored so many great goals, when you just invite pressure like that time and time again, you're gonna give up goals. And there were a few that were unlucky. Bounces off of Rizzo, for instance, like the one we just saw there. But you just can't play so slow sometimes. You just need to change it up to adapt. We saw Bako and Jelly adapt. We didn't see the same from Steph and Rizzo.
Yeah, I mean, you only really saw one. This critical goal here, just to put that one in, the way that the defender, you saw the one defender from G2 up in the corner not able to make the touch that he needs to. And you know, you could easily look at it and be like, oh, there were some mistakes. There was a lot of mistakes that were made or some own goals. But really, in a game with 11 goals, you're gonna have some fantastic offensive power there. You can't really blame the defense and all of that. These teams were really playing on fire.
Right. I mean, I would agree. They did actually play great offense on both sides, but I feel that Steph and Rizzo should not have conceded that match. Definitely a big blunder there between the two of them. They won't be looking to let that happen again.
We'll see how they move forward here. G2 dropping game one after I mean, I predicted a 3-1, so we're still on track for mine. But let's be honest, Iowa had all my eggs in the G2 basket here. Oh! See, Jelly to Bacco, that would have been the most nuts pass I'd seen in a 2v2 game ever if they completed that one there. But Jelly now looking for Bacco again. Playing on the ceiling, such a dangerous position in 2v2, and he gets the second touch as well. Two players up in the corner. Jelly will back off, very low on boost. Steph hangs in net, and right now G2 looking very timid in the beginning of game two. Scared to press out on offense. Here they'll finally move out. He's got Rizzo in support. Immediately turns around with that touch. Gets it over the top of Jelly, looks for Steph on the wall, but is not able to find him. Now the pinch from Rizzo, out in the middle. Jelly's up. Good positioning as Steph was in position to take the shot. Jelly's able to get that one, but there's G2 again. Rizzo now, can he finish this one off? No, shut down by Bacco. Going for the long plays, looking for a bit more of kind of a boomer situation than a dribble play. And so far, it's been completely matched toe-to-toe by the leftovers.
The biggest difference between the play from the leftovers of this match and last match, they're playing so much more confidently this match. We see them really aggressing against Rizzo and Steve, and not in the...
There you go. Steve able to finally find the hole in the defense. It's G2 that scores first again.
It was a great play here from Rizzo to bait in Jelly all the way out of net. And Bacco had not rotated back into the net, and he wasn't ready to account for the shot there from Steph. And what we really need to see here from Bacco and Jelly really is just to be a little bit more clinical with their shots. They're having great pressure. They just need to keep those rotations up and be able to put a few more of them on target a little bit better, not shooting right at Rizzo or right at their opponents.
Bacco to try and wrap this one around. Jelly hangs back in midfield. Now he'll try to see if he can put some pressure on. Kind of just the one-man offensive rotations here. Steph finds Rizzo. He does not make contact, but the ball makes it all the way to the corner. Bacco to play it away. Rizzo in. Good read by Jelly, dropping in front of his teammate. Now to go back around. Bacco's there to try and take a shot. He misses. Rizzo has an opportunity. He picks up the boost and flies downfield. Steph is already waiting up, but he cannot find his teammate. Good decisions, good mindset from this team of G2, just could not execute. That is where the sub player of Steph can punish you.
Yeah, I think Steph was actually trying to, he figured that there was going to be a goal opportunity. He was going a little bit further forward, and Rizzo expecting him to wait closer to his teammate. And I think that Rizzo made the right decision there. You don't want to push too far into the other field and potentially give up a counterattack goal.
Rizzo got that one past Jelly. Steph lurking behind Bacco. He'll get it past another one. Now into the corner. It's up to Bacco. What does he do with this one? He'll be able to dribble it out. Rizzo being patient. They're just slowly breaking down the defense here as they bait out another player. It's just Jelly in the back. He thought Rizzo was about to challenge up, so he doesn't make the hard clear. That'll be Jelly now on the backboard. Bacco comes flying, and that's two players committed again. Can G2 do it this time? As Steph and Rizzo both went for that ball on the side. Steph's doing it all by himself at the moment. Just slowly bumping it through players. 1:52 left to go. And leftovers with a one-game lead in the series in our best of five. Left to do it two more times to knock out G2. But G2 going to try and tie it up here in game two. So drops it from the net. Jelly over to Bacco. Into the corner. Jelly moves to the midfield. Ball back on the touch from Rizzo. Steph now finding Rizzo upfield. He'll slow this down. Flick it high. It's over the defenders. Brings Jelly along with it. And now it's Steph. Bacco lofted long before Jelly will be able to send it into the corner. Where is Steph? He'll rotate in behind. Both teams going for the solo air plays, which more just gives over ball control to the opponents than does anything else, especially when your teammate's behind you. Can Jelly do this dribble here? He puts it past all the way, and it's a tie game.
What a shot here from Jelly. I think Steph rushing a little bit too hard to get the ball up the wall instead of putting it to his own corner, and Jelly with a great air dribble, crossbar and down. Rizzo unable to contest it. Great job there from Jelly. He's shown throughout this whole series that he is no joke.
Absolutely. So Bacco over to the side. This leftovers roster leaving nothing to be desired. Playing like a top caliber team right now against top caliber players. And it's G2 now with the tie game that they have to deal with once more. Can they finish it off? Jelly sends it away. Steph with the read now into the corner. Pass to one, out to Rizzo. Pass two, does it go in? It goes bar down. Can Stev turn this one around? He does put that one in. G2's got the lead, and there's only 31 seconds left.
Yeah, fantastic effort here from Rizzo to go off the crossbar from that pass from Stev. And Stev, recognizing that the defender is just completely out of the play, he takes his time, puts a great shot on target.
Yeah, that is a methodical play right there. They play into the corner, which baits out one defender. They take a shot, and the remaining defender has to make the save. And then the third shot's there. Excellent rotation from G2s. They regain the lead here in game two.
With 20 seconds left.
I mean, that bump on Stev just bumped Bako so hard in net.
Now, I'm surprised you haven't seen more of those bumps, actually.
It's hard. You know, bumping is maybe more difficult than touching the ball because the ball's wanting to run away from you and the ball is sentient that you're trying to bump it, right? So it's a play you have to go and you have to, especially to get a demo, you have to play very, very hard into them to get it off. So I think it's maybe not worth the risk.
Yeah.
And so we don't see it as often here, but G2 able to take the victory in game number two. We're tied back up at a game apiece here in the series. And game five is looking like we're going to be going there if the leftovers continue to play at this level. So many fewer shots in this game as
exactly
both teams hunker down the defense.
Say. Like a third of the shots that were in the first game. I mean, Jelly doing a great job there with Bakadu on defense. And Stev and Rizzo struggling a lot more this match, I think, than the last one. They were giving up careless goals in the last game. But this game, it feels like both teams so evenly matched. I mean, look at this air dribble from Jelly. Wow!
Yeah, I don't remember the last time I saw that beautiful of an air dribble at this level of competition. But I think what's interesting to note is that the two goals from G2 both came from breaking down the defense, forcing defenders to come out of net, and then taking an easy shot at the net. But with the one goal we saw from the leftovers, a ridiculous clutch air dribble on two star players here, with Rizzo on the team. You air dribbled Rizzo. He balled Rizzo. You can just say that.
Put it on the resume. I balled Rizzo.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's no joke. Rizzo, I talked about before, and Stev, I expected a little bit more consistency from the two of them, just kind of lacking so many different places. But we're going to be looking to see them kind of just play a little bit more solid. They definitely looked better towards the end of that match, but a far cry from the first series where we've seen Jelly and Bakadu step it up.
I mean, anything can happen at this point. We've seen both teams take a game, and both games decided by one goal. Ridiculous games here so far in our semifinals. Can Rizzo finish this off? No, Bako will send it over the side. Now Stev, the pass towards Rizzo. Does a nice drift turn there. Immediately turn around, gives Stev an opportunity to drop this in. Does it go through? No, it touches the crossbar again. That crossbar has been plaguing G2 all day. Jelly do this one all by himself? No, Stev will send that one high, and Rizzo will keep it in the corner. By time for Stev to get regrounded in net. He's probably going to have to make another save here as Stev continues to sit. Jelly and Bako putting on the pressure. In the first minute here, Jelly puts it past one. Goes over to the side. And just look at this. Look at this rotation from us from leftovers. The way that they're able to keep this ball in the blue corner. This is the most stifling offensive pressure we've seen yet. Finally, G2 breaks out and puts it into the orange corner. Jelly's right here. Fall on this, try to pinch it off. Stev, has he faked this one out? No, Jelly's underneath, understands right where he needs to be, sends that one back around. First minute will come and go quietly here in game three.
Yeah, really, Rizzo playing so slow this game. We saw him on defense in his own corner. He wasn't getting baited for anything. He's just waiting for the key opportunity where we're going to see Jelly or Bakke going for a pass or a shot, and those are the ones that he wants to stop, not just the normal touches on the wall.
Stev to try and wrap it around. Here comes Rizzo with a shot towards the net. Such speed. The speed of that shot is what made it such a good goal. Makes it so difficult for it to save. G2's on the board first.
Yeah, we see 136 kilometers per hour. That is a fast shot. Wow, even going off the other team, the defender.
That is almost unblockable at that speed, especially at that range. Rizzo able to put that one in. Now G2, I believe G2 so far. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe G2 has scored first every game across both of their rosters, I believe. But now Bako with an opportunity. Rizzo gets it past him. He's up in the air. Can he double tap this one in? He does. That's that pro level Rocket League coming to show.
Yeah, double taps have become a huge part of the Rocket League meta as the car control and the skill has grown within the players. And we just see him place it right in the top corner. The defender had no idea where to go. Didn't even jump.
That is such an offensive, like, it so favors the offender in that situation because he can put the ball wherever, and he chooses the exact right place to put it. There's the upper 90 corner, that's where you want to go, but what does the defender do? Go hover up in that corner and then have him shoot it underneath him? You know, there's almost nothing you can do as a defender than just try to block any portion of the net and just hope he shoots at you. That's G2 now with the lead, the 2-0 lead. We've seen what happens with G2 at 2-0 leads. Hopefully they can hold on this time. Approaching halftime. Bako trying to put this one through. Jelly over the top.
I'd almost say it's worse with G2A. I mean, they didn't give up just two goals. They gave up like 12.
Yeah, that was 11 goals were scored in that first game. And now Rizzo to take a shot towards the net. Excellent save from Bako to send that one away. It looked like it was going through. But Steph with the hover play to try and send it through. Rizzo committed as well. He's going to have to hightail it back very quickly as Jelly is inbound to create pressure. The touch from Rizzo buys time, but it just sets it up for Bako. Steph has to make the save, and he does. They'll hold on to the 2-0 score margin. So playing this one soft. Both defenders plenty of time to get set up and get boost. Rizzo gets it past one, but it's Bako now that they've got to deal with on the wall, and he'll pinch that one off far down. Luckily, Rizzo is already rotating back. He'll be able to create pressure on Jelly. Try and get it over the top here. See if he can get this one through.
Yeah, there's a few opportunities there. Actually, we saw a couple miscommunications.
Oh, Steph. Good opportunity, drops this one in with a backflip shot. G2's really getting warmed up now. Steph starting to fit in here with Rizzo.
Everyone who's watching home just saw Steph raise those eyebrows. Look at this fake. The car turn at the last second completely deceives the defenders as to where the ball's going to go. It's super important as a defender to look at the car orientation of the attacker, see where they're going to put the ball. But when you make turns like that, it can be so difficult to make a right save.
Now it's Jelly. Gonna take a shot, brings out Stev, open net, Bako, can he drop this one through? He does, finds it past Rizzo, broken down rotation there from G2, and we'll see leftovers on the board.
Yeah, that was actually a great shot there from Jelly to put it off that corner, and Bakudu just cleaning it up, Rizzo unable to get back in time.
Well, it was Bako put it behind him. They were toe-to-toe, and then Bako just like slows it down and drops it right behind Rizzo as he rotates in. What a play there. Leftovers, so much to play for here. It would be quite the statement to be able to say you knocked out Rizzo and Stev in the semifinals of the Universal Open. But in game three, both teams won one game, so it's basically just back down to the best of three here. So we'll go down at least game four, possibly game five. But with 1:18 left to go, it is G2 with the strong lead, the two-goal lead. All they've got to do is hold on, secure game three. Rizzo and Stev both very heavily committed there. You see Stev landing perfectly, keeps his momentum, able to turn around, and then Rizzo getting the demo into Jelly. This will mean ball control for G2. They'll pinch bounce that shot off each other.
I don't know if it was a pinch. I think he just slammed his car into his teammate.
Stev trying to send this one through. Jelly, rather. Now Bako on the side. Pinch is high. Stev sitting in net, waiting for the shot from Jelly.
This is just like a battle of attrition. They're waiting for mistakes to be made, not just in where you challenge, but also in the 50-50s. There's a big opportunity every time we see these two cars go for 50-50. And for everyone at home, just to remind you, it could be 50-50 when two players are challenging the ball at the same time and the two cars meet. And you just, it's so crazy to see both these players, or both teams, sorry, so consistently clearing the ball against each other, unable to find this opening. And it's horrible with 15 seconds left. I mean, we're going to need to see Bakudu and Jelly really put on the pressure.
They have to at this point, but so far it's just been back and forth with G2 here in game three. As this time, if the timer hits one, hits zero, the game is essentially over at this point. You can't score two in 0 seconds. G2 taking game number three here in our best of five. They are now one away from knocking out the leftovers after the leftovers took game one in exciting overtime fashion.
I mean, really well done, I think, from G2A this match, just to kind of, they recognized that leftovers weren't pressuring as hard as they needed to towards the end of the match. When you go up so many goals, we see 8 shots from G2A and only 6 from leftovers, but I guarantee you none of those 6 were even in the last minute or two.
Yeah, you see G2 in control of this match. This is the best they've looked so far in the series. The shots that they've been putting on have been nothing but beautiful. Rizzo with some amazing stuff, the double tap here. Highly mechanical play, but such a deadly play if you can pull it off.
Right, and Steph, just completely deceiving the other two. Look at that rhythm. Yeah, blowing up the air. He knew that was cold.
That was gorgeous stuff here. And moving into game four, now the Leftovers have dropped two in a row. Thoughts about what the Leftovers need to do going up against G2? They've dropping the two games. They had that game one where they looked so close, but it's slowly starting to feel like it's slipping away from them. What do the Leftovers need to do?
I think we need to see more pressure coming from them. They were doing a really great job at first that game. I mean, I'm sure you could see it. Rizzo and Steph just stuck in their own corner, and it wasn't so dangerous, but at least they had control of the match. We need to see them playing a lot faster, more urgency. I mean, they don't want to go out. If they lose this game, it is over for them.
It is over. Their run would end here. After knocking Tribune out 2-0, the Leftovers on match point, trying to stay alive here in the Universal Open. One of these teams is going home this match. That's the story. From the quarterfinals and the semifinals, can he get this one? Oh, Rizzo's so close to putting in another double tap. But this one is not quite on target. Stev now with the opportunity. He'll have his own chance to be a hero. Loses ball control. Might have run out of boost there. Jelly moves up. Look at this tight offensive rotation here. They're so close to each other. A good clear from the Leftovers could easily punish.
But I don't think that they're letting them ever get the chance to clear the ball with that kind of pressure. It's a little bit of a double-edged sword where it just takes one error and that clear will just completely dismantle all pressure.
Oh my goodness, he puts it in the wall, dribble to shot. Stev playing like the best of them right now.
This is just a pure outplay. Stev recognizes Jelly on the back wall. There's no way he's getting back to cover the far side of the net all the way on the back wall, and Stev puts an easy, easy wall shot right into the net.
Another fun fact, we were talking about this earlier, Stev also a KBM player.
Yeah, what's with the KBM players coming to the Universal Open? It's crazy.
Here comes Bako. Trying to play it behind Stev, who just stalls it and lets Rizzo move in with full momentum. Rizzo there caught up. He wasn't sure whether to go for the ball or go for the boost first. But he's able to get the pinch around the side. Stev now into the air. Can he do this? What the flip plays? Rizzo, the players are all loose in net. Can he put it through?
No,
it's off the post. Stev rotates back quickly. And he'll actually miss that one, but Rizzo all the way in the back. The defense has been flustered right now from the Leftovers. They have to thank their lucky stars. They haven't scored yet. And Rizzo's still knocking at the door.
I mean, this is the kind of pressure I was expecting to see from Rizzo and Steph, and just kind of choking out the other team, not letting them breathe at any point, but we didn't see it last game, and the game before, they just wanted to hold their lead, but we see Rizzo and Steph, I don't think they want to win by just one goal.
Steph sends that one away. Winning by one goal is always terrifying. Steph, excellent placement towards the net, just barely wide. The fact that he was able to get that close with that angle. Crazy Rizzo now going to come off the wall. Roll that one back in. Trying to bait in Jelly or Bako, either one. Create the power play. Rizzo rotates around, sends this one into the side, goes for the half flip and turns himself back around. That'll be Bako now moving upfield, taking a shot towards the net. Rizzo will send it away. Coming up on halftime here, still 1-0 in favor of G2. As they have match point here, if they get the win on this one, they move forward into the grand finals. They qualify for the finals of the Universal Open.
Anybody qualifying for the finals of the Universal Open will be also qualifying for the grand finals at the same time. I think right now, the amount of pressure that we see being put on top of Bako and Jelly, they need to be able to get some demos, some bumps. They need to do something to alleviate that pressure.
Jelly. Have an opportunity here. Bako will have the open net. Both defenders are both offensive players. Both of G2, all the players in G2 over and in the wrong half. And that's just going to be a completely open net here for Bako as they tie it up. They have stayed close so many times here. They keep these games just within a hair's length away from victory. They need the victory here if they want to be able to have that game five. They've got to win two straight to stay alive in the Universal Open. Right now, G2's not making it easy. But an open net like that, and Rizzo almost sends that one into his own net as well. And we'll stay away, and we'll stay tied up at one apiece. Jelly down to Bako. What does he do? He pops it up. Jelly now in the air. Stev confused in net. He'll still make the play, keeping that one away as Jelly's shot headed straight down towards him. Now Bako down the field. What we saw at the beginning of this game was stifling offensive pressure from G2, and now it's starting to turn around a little bit as the Leftovers getting more and more opportunities in the opponent's territory. But G2 still threatening. Jelly lofts this one high. Stev moves up. Can he carry this one along? Full boost. feathers it out to give as much distance as possible. Rizzo just waits. Steph goes to try and zone out the goalie. Rizzo gets bumped by Baca, which opens up a lot of opportunities for Jelly. Rizzo still on the wall, able to be a nuisance. As we are approaching this final minute, it's still tied up at one apiece.
And such low-scoring games. I mean, I expected a little bit from Rizzo.
Such low-scoring games of the last three.
Oh yeah.
First game was 11 goals. This
okay,
has been crazy.
Okay, fair. Fair. I mean, towards the end of this, because those games had so many errors and just unforced errors as well. So I think that was deceiving. But Rizzo, I mentioned his defense is one of his primary attributes, and I think Steph as the substitute is really starting to show as his match. You're not seeing the same synergy you would see with Rizzo and JNaps.
See Rizzo over the side. Jelly in to try to take a shot. Rizzo able to dunk it through and now into the corner. Steph moves into the midfield, and you know the leftover defenders have to be rotating quickly. Baca gets that one away. Steph was hoping to get it through all the defenders. Now it's his turn to move this one up. 30 seconds left in this game. Possibly 30 seconds remaining before G2 can qualify for the finals if they get able to get one more goal in here. The leftovers having to win this game and then one more going to game five. But the shot from Steph, it goes in past Jelly. The pressure finally makes the leftovers crack and they're down by one.
Oh, with 13 seconds left, we see Bakudo just not go for the greatest challenger, and Jelly leaving the back of his net undefended is going to be a huge error there. It's going to put them in behind. 13 seconds left. They have to make something happen on this kickoff.
They have to score right now if they want to stay alive. Jelly to send this one onto the backboard. Good opportunity. If he had been able to put that one into the net on the far side, that would have been a tie game again, and we'd be going to overtime. But oh dear, the miss from Baca. They lose so much time on that one. It goes loose again. Both players losing touch on the ball, and G2's able to clinch it out. They qualify for the finals. They qualify for the grand finals in Santa Ana.
I mean, well done to this G2A roster. I think they're going to be so happy, especially with Steph. We talked about the story. JNaps snowed in August. Like, what's going on? And being able to come out and pull through all the way to the finals, guaranteeing them that spot in, and like you said, is going to be huge.
It's crazy. We talked about it. The first game, so many goals. And then here, only three shots from the leftovers, six from G2A, nine shots total. I feel like both teams had nine shots in the first game by themselves. Nine shots total here in this game. A save a piece across the board as these teams trying to push it all the way through, but G2A able to pull it out. And this semifinal match was nothing but exciting all the way through. This game was down to the wire, the final goal being scored at 13 seconds.
Right. Oh, look at that shot there from Steph. He caught Jelly off on the wall, and we see from both sides errors on defense, and that might have to say something for the future for this Rizzo and Steph roster. If they were to concede so many goals against a team that definitely seemed to be a little bit outclassed by Rizzo and Steph, well, that's just not going to spell well for them.
It's so high risk, high rewards in 2v2. If you commit the two players to get the crazy goal, you open yourself up on the other end. We saw that happen time and time again here, but G2 coming out with the victory.
Yeah, no kidding. I mean, they looked great as well. And we're going to take a look at the bracket here so we can see G2A makes it into the finals. They have qualified for the grand finals in Santa Ana. Talk to me guys about that. So we're gonna move into the second semifinal here in just a second. That is going to be G2P versus Ascension. We'll be right back after this.